Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we'll see different types of pattern command. So we know that basically we are using two types of pattern. First one is rectangular pattern and second one is circular pattern. So today we'll see that rectangular pattern in detail. So you can see this object is made by the rectangular pattern. So how we are going to create this object by using a rectangular pattern. So before going to start my rectangular pattern, I just created this slab here. Now we have to create a sketch on the surface of this slab. I'm just using a simple circle here. Then give the dimensions to our circle here. Suppose dimension is 15 mm diameter, and we have to define our dimensions from both end point of all this is again 20. Again, this one will be the 20 exit workbench. I'm just using simple command as a pocket here, pocket up to last. So no need to give the dimension here. Preview OK. Now you can see here we just removing this material from our block or slab here. Now we have to use here a rectangular pattern. So you can see in transformation feature, the first one is rectangular pattern. This is our pattern toolbar. Now we have to select our rectangular pattern. Select rectangular pattern. Now which command we have to use as a rectangular pattern. So again we have to use that in object as a current solid means this pocket, and give the reference elements on which surface we have to create our pattern. So this is our base surface. Now you can see here there are the two directions are given to you. This is our first direction and this is our second direction. So we have to change our direction. This is our first direction, so first direction is okay. Now related to our second direction, so we have to reverse, make it reverse position. So you can see here this is our second direction position. Now in first direction position, first one is our instance and spacing. So you can see here first one is instance and length, instance, spacing, spacing, length, instances, unequal spacing. So we'll see here one by one. First one is instance and length. So how much instance we required on the both side? This is our direction 1 and directions 2. So according to that we have to specify our instance. Suppose we need here a 4 instance, and length between these two instances again are the total length which is required to accumulate our specimen here or command. So that would be 160. So you can see here it's showing as a more. So we have to reduce our length here around 110, because we are keeping 20-20 mm on both side directions. So you can click on preview button. So this is related to instance and length. So similarly we can use our second direction dimension here. Again instance and length. So how many instances required? Suppose 8 instances required. Now the length between instance is related. We know that the total length of this slab is 300 mm. So according to that we have keep a distance of the center point to this edge is 20. So again we have to maintain the same distance on both sides. So 20 and 20 is a 40. So 300 minus 40 is nothing but a 260. So we have to mention here a 260. So we can see here. So we can get uniformity of the specimen or object on the surface of or this component. Click on preview button and OK button. Now you can see here, this is very simple rectangular pattern. Again, if you want to edit, so just double click on our pattern here. So you can again change our dimension here, like this one. Suppose we just need a 3 instead of 4. In second direction we just need only a 7. Click on OK. you can say 1, 2 and 3 and again say 1. So like this one. Again double click for the modification process. Now second one is instant and spacing. Now again look at this instant and spacing. So instance is required 4 and spacing between these two instances, again suppose I am just giving here a only 30 mm is the spacing distance. So you can observe here from center to center point the distance between these two circle is the 30 mm. Click on preview. And similarly you can change our second direction dimensions. So again suppose 10 and I am using a instance and spacing, so spacing would be 20 here. Preview. So we can use our pattern by using our instance and spacing here. Again the next option is given here as the instance, spacing and length here. Spacing and length means how much spacing is required and length is required between these two is. So instance is, spacing is suppose I am using as a 40 and length is a 90. So again click on preview here, so you can see here there's a 40 or spacing between these two is or 40. So this 40 distance is given here and total length would be 90 here. Now in second directions again same way, spacing and length. So spacing again I'm using as a 30 and distance is 180. Instead of that we are just changing our 260 here. Preview, look at this. So we are just changing our dimension with the help of that. Click on OK. So we will get our output by using this rectangular pattern. Now again another option is same, that instance and unequal spacing. So we can use unequal spacing here. So how many instances is required here? Suppose instance, click on preview here. Unequal spacing, first one is our 40 here, this one is 40, you can see here the spacing is given as a 40 here. So I just need to click here and change our spacing is 450. Then again we have to select the another dimension and suppose this is 30. So click on preview, or you need to again add some instance here. So you can change the dimension of that is 20 here. So this is unequal dimension. So you can clearly observe here this is unequal dimensions. So by using that you can easily made any type of structure with the help of this rectangular pattern. I hope that you like this my session, and please kindly subscribe and share my channel. Thank you.